Thank you very much, Janine, and thank you to MPAC. This is a terrific opportunity to talk about who we are as candidates and to really look at the issues and the opportunities before us. As you know, Yonkers is the fourth largest city in New York State. And I don't disagree with my opponent that there's many issues that confront our city. What I say is that what issues have you dealt with? If you're a resident of Yonkers, what have you done the last 20, the last 30, the last 40 years that shows your commitment, your involvement, and your opportunity to address those issues? I come before you as a candidate for the 90th Assembly seat, and I am someone that can tell you, having lived in this city for 60 years, growing up as an immigrant, and I appreciate the value of the hard work mothers commit to their children, because I have a mother that lost her husband at the age of 39, and she raised 8 children, and I was the third of 8 children. And we lived and grew up on Southwest Yonkers, on Waverly Street, on Buena Vista. We had to shine shoes at a very early stage to pay for our free lunch. It wasn't free, we paid for it. And I understood the importance of a quality education. All of us were taught that. We grew up and achieved our goals as medical doctors and lawyers and educators and teachers and so forth, because that was the value system instilled in us. And I went on after college to get involved with organizations in Southwest Yonkers serving minority children and getting involved with civic services on the agenda of children in need and high need students. And I was very instrumental in developing and working closely with the NAACP during the days of integration, and working with the Spanish Community Progress Foundation in developing organizations and services that deal with immigration and education and housing and healthcare. And I went on to not only be served as a teacher, to serve as a school principal for over 30 years. And I went on to become, after I retired, an attorney at law that understood the law, and went on to serve. This is my 6th year on the Board of Education. And I serve as a volunteer, and I can tell you that when a person seeks to run for office, they need to show a commitment to the job they're looking to seek to serve. And my opponent talks very eloquently about what he's concerned about, and conservation, of course, is a very important area for all of us. My main concerns include conservation and clean energy, but my goal, and I think the biggest issue impacting our city, is education, is housing, is crime, and it's small businesses that are beginning to be phased out in our community. And I pledged to fight the system. I think we all agree there's many years of corruption, there's many years of a lack of adequate services for our city. Namely, as an educator, I know that Yonkers gets shortchanged each and every year. We get shortchanged by the state funding formula. The state funding formula tells us that Yonkers is part of Westchester County, and therefore, as a rich county, Yonkers gets a lot less money per child than all the other big urban school districts in New York, namely Buffalo and Rochester and Syracuse. When I, as a trustee, made an issue out of that, public officials, not only locally but on the state level, said this is a formula that impacts the entire state. Don't waste your time trying to change it. We went up there and we fought and we demanded, we wanted to know, what is this formula? And what is it based on? Is it based on high needs of students? how many special ed kids the school district serves, how many English language learners the school district serves, what is the enrollment of the school? Well, primarily it's based on the wealth of the county, and you're part of Westchester County, and that's a rich county. And then I looked at it and I said, well, I want to see the figures. I want to see the numbers. When we started to look at the numbers, and you would be so angry and so concerned, it wasn't a small amount that was different between what Buffalo gets per kid and what we get in Yonkers. The numbers, just for the record, in the other big urban settings is $12,000 a year per child every year that those other big city school districts get. You know what Yonkers gets? We get $7,000 a year of state aid per child every year. So when you look at 26, 27,000 kids in our city that we serve, that get $5,000 a year, then they say to us, why is Yonkers year after year coming up and begging us for more money? Because we are shortchanged. And this is why over the years we see cuts in sports and cuts in music and art. And I will advocate, and I will go up to Albany working, you heard earlier from State Senator Andrea Stewart Cousins. Politically, let me explain to you, there's a state senate and there's the assembly. There's two houses that are the legislative branches of government in New York State. Andrea Stewart Cousins, our senator, most likely would be the next majority leader of the state senate. Shelley Mayer, our senator, and that's the seat I'm looking to replace, will be working very closely with Senator Cousins. And as a state assemblyman, you need to know that the New York State Assembly is controlled and primarily a Democrat body. And that seat to elect a Republican conservative, you would be causing the biggest setback for our city. Not only would you be part of a minority government, you would force that representative to be on the minority end and be unable to work with the controlling factor, so that when you fight for greater state aid, when you fight for greater services for our city, you would be at a shortchange. I bring to you 40 years of experience. I bring to you volunteer services, where when you look at my track record for 40 years, you would see a track record of commitment, a track record where I've never gained a dime for that service. It costs me a lot of time and effort, but it's my commitment to our students, and it's my commitment to make sure that somebody goes up to Albany that can just talk the talk, but walk it and have the experience and the know-how and the connections and the collaboration to bring about that success we need. I pledge to you a continuation of working with Senator Stewart Cousins, Senator Shelley Mayer, Assemblyman Gary Pretlow, to work together to make sure that Yonkers schools in our city gets the services they deserve. So put the talk aside, look at the experience, look at the track record, and look at who can deliver, as I have for 40 years. Thank you very much.